Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Electronics for You. Friends, in this video I will talk about transfer function using Mason's gain formula, or we can say that to find the transfer function for a signal flow graph. Now we should know the Mason's gain formula first. So we know that the objective of a block diagram reduction technique is to find the transfer function of the system, and in block diagram reduction technique we use the multiple times reduction rules to solve a block diagram, and we find the transfer function of the same block diagram. Now same is the objective of our signal flow graph by using Mason's gain formula. So signal flow graph is also used to find the transfer function of the system, and in transfer function we use one formula, and it is known as Mason's gain formula to find the transfer function for the block given signal flow graph. And thus we can say that by using one formula we can find the transfer function of the system, and it is possible in case of the signal flow graph by using Mason's gain formula. And that's why signal flow graph is easier technique as compared to our block diagram reduction technique, because in block diagram reduction technique we use the block diagram reduction rule, and we should know all the block diagram reduction rules for the solution of the given block diagram. Now this is the Mason's gain formula, and we can find here that it is C of S upon R of S is equals to summation from 1 to N Pi delta I upon delta. Now these are the some notations used here, and we should know what this notation actually indicates. So first of all we will find N, actually where N is the number of forward paths. So number of forward path will decide this Pi and delta I, because P is nothing but our ith forward path. Means if you are having some three forward paths, then we will write P1 delta 1 plus P2 delta 2 plus P3 delta 3, because this summation is indicating actually the sum of all these forward path. Now delta I is the determinant of the ith forward path. Now I will explain it further in our next slide. And this delta is the determinant of the system. Now what is the actual formula for calculation of delta is explained here. This is our given formula, and delta is the determinant of the system, and it can be calculated as the formula for this delta is this one. It is it will look like somewhat complex formula, but actually it is not. See here that delta is equals to 1 minus sum of all individual loop gains including self loop gains. So it is 1 minus sum of all individual loop gains, then plus sum of all gain product of two non-touching loops. Okay, here it is two non-touching loops, that is plus sum of all the gain products of two non-touching loop, then minus sum of all gain product of three non-touching loop, then plus sum of all gain products of four non-touching loop, and so on. In fact it may be 5, 6, but most of the times there may be 3 or 4 non-touching loop for the complex problem. Otherwise sometimes there will be no non-touching loop will be there, but it is another matter. See here that we are having this formula here, this minus sign is there, then plus, then minus, plus, etc. Means we will use first negative sign, and further it will be positive term, then negative term, then positive term, and so on. So therefore we can say that it is actually a simple formula. Now this delta, we can indicate these things, these are nothing but this individual loop gains, then two non-touching loop gains by some notations here, and these are the notations used for this. Okay, so in this case we are using sum of all individuals loop gain. Now loop gain, individual loop gains are indicated by L1, L2, L3, etc. Then two non-touching loops are indicated by L12, L22. Here this two will indicate that it is the pair of two non-touching loops, and 1, 2, 3 will indicate the numbers here. Again in this case the three non-touching loops are indicated like this, and again 1, 2, 3 will indicate the number of these pairs, and 3 will indicate the 3 non-touching loops. Similarly, 4 will indicate 4 non-touching loop, and 1, 2, 3, etc. Will indicate the total number of non-touching loops pair. Now this is the formula for delta, and delta I is the value of ith forward path from the graph. Now friends, if you don't know this thing, that is individual loop gains, 2 non-touching loops, 3 non-touching loop, etc. These are the some basic concepts I already explained in the given video here, and you can watch this by clicking on I button, or you can watch you can see the link there in our description. Now, if you want to continue the same, you can continue here. This is the Mason's gain formula, and here if this delta I is again can be explained by 1 minus all the loops that do not touch the ith forward path. See here that this is the non-touching loop. Okay, so this is non-touching loop, and definitely it will be 1 minus all the non-touching loop. And if non-touching loops are not there for the forward path, then it is simply delta I equal to 1, because this term will be equal to 0, and therefore delta I will be equal to 1. Now this we'll see the steps to find transfer function using Mason's gain formula. And here the first step is to calculate the ith forward path, that is PI. So we have already seen the our formula for the Mason's gain, and we will use some concepts related with the same here. These are the terms. The first one is the calculation of ith forward number of forward path, and we'll name it as P1, P2, P3, etc. Then we will find the total number of loops, individual loops. Then we will find the 2 non-touching loops there, we will find 3 non-touching loops, and so on. So this will be our step number 3, 4, 5, etc. It will be continued. Okay, it may be 6 number step, 7 number step, but here in explanation I am ending the same terms here. Now these things will be used in our formula to calculate the delta. So delta is equals to steps from 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. Whichever applicable. Note here that whichever applicable steps are there, you will use 4, 5, 6, etc. there in our next step. And our next step will be the calculation of delta I as the portion of delta, that is non-touching forward path. I already explained it, but you will get it in example more clear. So our 8th number step is to find the transfer function using formula, and our formula for this one is this is the formula, and we will use it in our terms. And actually the same formula can be written like this. Let us see one example of a signal flow graph. Here the problem is to calculate the transfer function of a system represented by following signal flow graph. And one signal flow graph is there, given there, and we have to find the transfer function for this signal flow graph. Definitely we will use Mason's gain formula to calculate it, and our solution, our step number 1 will be to obtain total number of forward path. Now we know that forward paths are the paths from input to output. Okay, so a path from input to output. Now if we move this from this path, that is in the direction of arrow, then we can see here that this is our one forward path. It is indicated here, and this is our forward path, and the transfer function for this forward path will be, let this forward path be P1, and the transfer function for this forward path will be equal to 1 multiplied by G1 multiplied by G2 multiplied by G3 multiplied by G4. Okay, again multiplied by 1 will be our forward path. This is our first forward path. Now our second forward path, we can see here that this is our second path. Now if you move through this G5, again you will bypass this G2, G3 and G4, but we will move to the output, and therefore our next forward path is this one, and therefore let it be P2. And here the transfer function for this will be 1 multiplied by G1 multiplied by G5 multiplied by 1, that is G1 multiplied by G5. So this is our step number 1. Now our step number 2. और स्टेप नंबर टू इज टू कैलकुलेट ऑल द नंबर ऑल सिंगल लूप्स और वी कैन से दैट इंडिविजुअल लूप्स. नाउ सी हियर दैट लूप्स आर वी हैव टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम वन पॉइंट एंड वी हैव टू एंड विद द सेम. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट एंड इफ यू मूव थ्रू दिस G1, G2 एंड इफ यू कैन कम बैक टू दिस सेम पॉइंट दैट इज टू द सेम नोड देन इट इज कॉल्ड एज लूप एंड वी कैन सी हियर दैट दिस इज अवर फर्स्ट लूप. लेट दिस लूप बी L1. Let this loop will be L1 and the transfer function for this L1 will be G1 multiplied by G2 multiplied by minus H3. So I will write H3 here with a negative sign here. So the transfer function for this path will be equal to minus G1 G2 H3. Now our second loop is nothing but this one. You can see here this is our one path where we can start from this node and we can end with the same node by going through this path, and let it be L2, and the transfer function for this will be G2 multiplied by G3 multiplied by H2 with the negative sign again. Then one more feedback path is there, you can clearly see L3, let it be L3, and its transfer function is G4 multiplied by H1 with negative sign again. So this is our L3, and the last single loop is again there. You can, it is not clearly visible, but you can see here that this is our forward path, and if you move through this, then this will be the our last single loop, that is nothing but L4. Let it be L4, and it will be equals to, the multiplication will be G4 multiplied by H1 multiplied by H2 with negative sign. Both are having negative sign, so further it will become positive. So G5 multiplied by H1 H2 is the transfer function for L4. These are our four single loops. Now this is our step number two, and let's move towards step number three, that is to find the total number of non-touching pairs. So here the non-touching pairs for two non-touching pairs. Now definitely we know that we are having four individual loops there. So this one first, this one is second, this is third, and this is fourth. If you consider this loop, that is L1, and this one, that is L3, then these are the only two non-touching loops present over here, and we can name it as L12. Let it be L12, and the sign for this will be the multiplication. Now we have to calculate the multiplication there. It will be G1, G2 multiplied by H3 with negative sign, that is minus H3. Then again multiplication for this loop, that is G4 and H1 is there with negative sign. Further, we can simplify it and we can write it as both negative sign will cancel each other, and it will be G1, G2, G4, H1, H3. I have just written it properly. So this is our two non-touching loops pair. Now in this case, our step number four will be to find out total number of three non-touching loops, and there is actually no three non-touching loop pair, because this and this loop were having a pair. But if we consider this one, definitely it will have this common path. So for non-touching pair, there should not be any common path, and therefore we can say that there are no three non-touching loops. Now this is our step number four, and let's move to our step number five to find out the delta, the value of delta. We know the formula, we have already used this formula. I have already explained this formula. Now in this case there was only one pair of two non-touching loop. Further, this term will not exist in our actual formula, and three non-touching loop, four non-touching loop, and five non-touching loops were not there. Therefore our formula will reduce to, and we were having single loop as L3 and L4, therefore our formula will reduce to this one. This is our actual formula here, and just put the values here. I have just put the values here. We have already found L1, L2, L3, L4 transfer function, as well as L12 transfer function. Just put the values and calculate it simplified. Just this negative sign will multiply this negative, negative, negative terms. These will become positive there. This positive term will become negative, and thus we found the value of delta here. So this is the value of delta. Now we have to find delta 1 and delta 2. Delta 1, how to find delta 1? This is the one of the most important thing. Now we know that this is our forward path. Now find any loop which do not touch this forward path. Now we know that this is a forward path where each and every loop is touching to this forward path, because they are having common nodes. If the common nodes are there, these are the our nodes, and as these nodes are on the forward path itself, for first forward path, that is P1, there will be no non-touch, no loop that will touch it. All the loop will touch it, and you will not find any loop there which is not touching to it. Therefore, the delta I, that is delta 1, will be equal to 1 here. It is 1 minus 0 equal to 1. If any non-touching loop pair is there, any non-touching loop is there, you can write the values of their gain here. Now this is our second forward path, and for this path also, this pair, this loop is touching there, then this loop is touching there, this loop is also touching there, because it is having this common path for this second one, and this common node here for this path. Therefore, again for forward path 2, all loops are touching there, and therefore delta 2 is also equals to 1. Now put the values here in our transfer function formula. As two paths are there, P1 and P2 will be there along with delta 1 and delta 2. Now we know the value of delta 1, delta 2. We know the value of P1, P2, that is forward pass. Already calculated the value of delta in our step number 5. Put the values there and find out the answer. This is our final answer, that is the transfer function of the given signal flow graph. You need not to calculate, you need not to draw this diagram everywhere. This is our one example of signal flow graph. We will continue some examples in our subsequent video. You can watch here, and this is our playlist where you can find the playlist in English as well as in Hindi. Please continue watching. Thank you.